Hello everyone, welcome to Nagesh Kadazgi Orchid School. I am Pooja Rajmani. I am your computer teacher. In last period, we discussed a paint and its more tool. What is the use of paint? To draw the different shapes. And we can write also in paint. How to write? By using text tool. Right. Now we will see our next number chapter. Name of the chapter is Lab Manners. Chapter number 8. Lab Manners. When we went in a computer lab, how to behave in a computer lab? It is called as a lab manners. We are going in computer lab for practice, right? When we enter in computer lab, how to behave in a computer lab? Which thing we have to do, which thing we don't have to do? First one we will see. Dear student, when you see the computer lab, you must follow certain safety rules for the maximum utilization of the computer time and energy. What is the use of computer? Computers save our time and energy, right? And computer is a machine. Computer is made by man or God? Yes, man. And computer is a which type of machine? Which type of device? Computer is a electronic device. Why it is called as an electronic device? Because it runs on the electricity. Same like a computer, there are different electronic devices. Which are they? Fan, refrigerator, television, etc. There are so many electronic devices. Then which thing we have to do when we enter in a computer lab? First one, always come to the computer lab from your classroom in a proper line. Computer lab is different and our classroom is different. When you are coming to the classroom to computer lab, we must have to come in a proper line. See here, in a proper line and keep distance between you and your friend. Right? Come in a proper line and proper time. Next one, always sit properly on the chair or stool by maintaining a distance of about 2 feet between your eyes and screen to protect your eyes. When we are going to computer lab, we must have to sit on a stool or chair. Whatever it may be there, stool is there or chair is there, we must have to sit on that properly. And we have to keep distance between monitor. Monitors look like a TV screen. We have to keep distance between, at least 2 feet distance between monitor and ourselves. Why? To protect our eyes. To protect our eyes, we must have to keep distance between monitor and ourselves. See here, the students are using the computer, but they are sitting properly and they are doing their work properly. They are sitting on chair. chair properly and they are keeping distance between monitor and their self. Same like that, we must have to sit when we enter in a computer lab. What is the first one thing? When we are coming to computer lab, we must have to come in a proper line and on a proper time. Next one, when we are sitting on the chair or stool, we must have to sit properly. And when we are sitting on that stool, keep proper distance between monitor and yourself. If you not keep distance, then your eyes maybe in future will damage. To protect our eyes, we must have to keep distance between ourselves and monitor. Next one, two or more students share one computer system, divide the time to do the practical assignment without fighting and making noise. If your friend not brought tiffin, then what will you do? Yes, you will share your tiffin, right? Same like that, if your friend's computer is not working or he or she don't having the computer, then how to help him? Yes, we must have to share the computer. But how to share the computer? By sharing the parts? No, not sharing the parts. Then how to share the computer? Sharing the parts means you take keyboard, I will take mouse. You take CPU, I will take monitor. Like that we have to share the computer? No, it is not way of the sharing the computer. It is not a proper way. Then how to share, how to help our friend? Yes, by using sharing the time, divide the time for doing the practical assignment. And computer having different parts. Which are the four main part of the computer? Yes, monitor, keyboard, mouse, CPU. These are the four main part of the computer. Instead of that, also having computer, which part? Printer, speaker, scanner, microphone. These are also parts of computer. Then one computer having four main parts. Without that four main parts, computer cannot work properly. If in computer lab having 30 or 35 computer, then it is the so many parts in that computer lab. That's why when we enter in a computer lab, don't touch any part without reason and don't fight with your friend. Don't push your friend. Why? Because it is the electronic device, and for working of the computer properly, we must have to connect all parts to the CPU. Means there are many wires are also there. They are connected with each other by using the wires. Then when we enter in a computer lab, don't make a noise and don't fight with your friend. Don't push your friend. If you push your friend, and suppose your friend will fall down on any part of the computer, then this friend having friend will also get shock, otherwise the parts will be damaged. Means when we are going in a computer lab, we must have to sit properly. Don't fight with your friend and don't make noise. Don't pull your friend. What is the first one? Always coming for the computer lab, always coming to the computer lab, must come in a proper line and on a proper time. If chair is there or stool is there, sit properly on that chair or stool and maintain the distance of about 5 feet between your eyes and the screen. Screen means what? Which part of the computer? What is the name of this part? Yes, monitor. And when you are sharing your computer with your friend, then share the timing, divide the timing for sharing. Don't share the parts of computer. Divide the timing, don't divide the parts. Don't fight with your friend and don't make the any noise. And last one, handle each part of the computer according to the instruction of the computer teacher. When you are coming to computer lab, already teacher is there. Then listen to your teacher. Why? Because computer run on electricity, right? Computer run on electricity means it is electronic machine. Computer is electronic machine and one computer having at least 4 parts. And these 4 parts are connected with each other by using the wire. Means there are so many wires are there, so many parts are there and so many computers are there in the computer lab. That's why when we come in a computer lab, we must have to listen to your teacher. Next one, see here, what the picture showing? Which thing we have to do when we enter in a computer lab? When you are coming to computer lab, we must have to come in a proper line and keeping distance between you and your friend. Next one, when you are sitting, then keep distance between monitor or screen and to yourself. When you are sitting on work, when you are doing practical, then don't talk with each other. Sit straight and don't talk with your friend. These things we must have to do when we enter in a computer lab. Now we will see which thing don't do when we enter in a computer lab. Do thing we will see one more time. Always come in proper line, sit properly, don't push your friend, keep distance between yourself and computer, don't fight your friend, don't make any noise. If two or more students are sharing the computer, then divide the time, don't divide the computer parts, and handle each part of the computer according to the instruction of your computer teacher. When you are coming to computer lab, when you are coming in computer lab, then keep your shoes outside. Why? because when you are going here and there, then that time we are using shoes continuously. Then our shoes having dust. If this dust, if you are coming with your shoes in a computer lab, then this dust may be enter in a parts of computer. Then there is a chance to get our parts damaged. That's why when we are coming to the computer lab, then keep your shoes outside. Now we will see which thing we don't have to do when we enter in a computer lab. Don't do. Don'ts. Do not touch any parts of the computer with wet hand. When you are using the computer, then your hand must be dry, not wet. Why? Because computer is a electronic machine. If you are touch any part of computer with wet hand, then we will get a shock. That's why whenever we are using the computer, then our hand must be a dry, not wet. Next one, do not eat or drink near the computer. Do not eat or drink near to the computer. Why? Because when we are eating something near to the computer, then when we are eating, then our hand will be oily. And with this oily hand, if we touch to the parts of computer, then our parts also will get oily. So that don't eat near to the computer. And why do not drink? Because computer is a electronic machine. By mistakenly, if water is fallen down or any drinking thing is fallen down and it will went in our parts, then computer is a which type of machine? Electronic machine. And if water is fallen down on that part, then what will happen? Yes, this part will be damaged and there is chance we will get a shock. That's why don't eat or drink near the computer. Next one, do not touch or pull any wire or plug. You might get an electric shock. Do not touch or pull any wire. Computer parts are different. At least one computer having four main part, and these parts are connected to each other by using the wire. Where we connect all parts to the which part? Yes, to the CPU. That's why CPU is called as the brain of computer. Whatever we are doing inside the computer, it is stored in CPU, and all parts are connected to the CPU. Right? Then these parts are connected to each other by using the wire, and computer having plug also, wire or plug. Do not touch or pull any wire or plug. Why? Because if you touch or pull, then you might get an electric shock. There is a chance to you get a electric shock. That's why do not touch or pull any wire or plug. Next one. Do not move in the lab from one place to another place. Do not move in the lab from one place to another place. Why? Because firstly you are sitting, and if you want to change your place, you are sitting means your legs with near the CPU, and all parts we are connecting to the CPU means there are so many wires are there. And if you are hurry and if you are moving the place, then your leg will be bent in that wire. So do not move when you enter in a computer lab. Sit in a one place only. Clear? Which thing don't have to do? Do not touch any part of computer with wet hand. Do not eat or drink near the computer. Do not touch or pull any wire or plugs. You might get an electric shock. Do not move in the lab from one place to another place. What is this picture showing? When you are using the parts of computer, then touch it very slowly. Do not touch part of computer hardly. Do not touch part of computer hardly. It is the laptop, and what they are doing? They are touching slowly? No. They are pressing hardly. Then it is good thing? No, it is bad thing. What is the second number picture showing? This boy is eating something and drinking something near to the computer. And what is the result? The drinking thing is fallen down on the keyboard. Then it is good thing? No. So that don't drink or eat near to the computer. Clear? Which thing we have to do? Always come to the computer lab from classroom in a proper line. Always sit properly on the chair or stool by maintaining distance of about 2 feet between your eyes and screen to protect your eyes. Two or more students share one computer system. Divide the time to the practical assignment without fighting and making noise. Handle each part of computer according to the instructions of your computer teacher. Do not touch any part of computer with wet hand. Do not eat or drink near the computer. Do not touch or pull any wire or plug. You might get an electric shock. Do not move in the lab from one place to another place. Do not touch the computer parts hardly. Now we will solve skill sheet. From your skill sheet, open page number 39. What is the first one? Question. Open first page number 39. Do's. painted the pictures showing the thing which one should do in the computer lab. Means which thing we must have to do when we enter in the computer lab. In front of that picture, we must have to tick it. Take pencil, we will solve this. What is the first number picture showing? These students are sitting and without talking with each other, they are using the computer, maintaining distance between computer and themselves. Then it is good or bad? Yes, it is good. Then we will tick here. What is the second number picture showing? These two students are sitting and using the computer by maintaining the distance, and they are pressing the computer key very properly. Then it is good or bad? Yes, this is also good thing. Then we will tick over here. What is the third number picture showing? When they are going to the computer lab, they are going in a proper line and keeping distance between them. Then it is good thing or bad thing? Yes, it is good thing. Then we will tick over here. Next one. When they are going in a computer lab, they are keeping their shoes outside only and in one proper line. Then it is good thing or bad thing? Good thing. Then we will tick here. Next one. She is eating in front of computer or near to the computer. Then it is good thing? No, it is not a good thing. Then we will not do anything here. And this last picture is showing. He is pressing laptop keys very hardly, very angrily. Then it is good thing? No, it is not a good thing. Then we will not do anything there. Why? Because what is the question? Only they told tick. They not told cross. Which thing are wrong? They not told to cross there. Then we will keep as it is. Do fast. Do tick fast by using pencil. Finish. Now turn the page. I read the question. What is the question? Take the picture showing the things which one should not do in the computer room. One should not do in a computer room means don't think, and there also we have to tick only, not to cross. Which thing don't do in a computer lab or computer room? First thing is, he or she pressing computer or laptop keys very hardly. Then it is good thing? No. Then we don't have to do this thing. Then we will cross over here. Second picture. He is pressing computer keys or laptop keys very hardly. Then it is also bad thing. Then we will tick there. Third thing, they are keeping shoes very properly in one single line. Then this thing we should have to do. Then don't do anything here. Then fourth one thing, see in your picture, this man is doing something on the computer and he having one glass also there for eating something, for drinking something. Then it is a good thing to drink or eat near to the computer? No. Then this thing we don't have to do in a computer lab. Then we will tick here. Second last thing, these students are sitting properly and using computer very properly, then it is good thing. And last thing, these both students are also sitting on the computer very properly and writing using the keyboard very properly. It is also good thing. Take only these three pictures. Why? Because this thing we should not do when we enter in the computer room. Now, what is the homework for you? Complete the skill sheet and read the lesson, underline the hard words. Thank you.